Everyone, this is Upasana saying ST at Flipkart, and I welcome you all to Online Study for You, a complete placement solution for everyone. Today, in this video, we are going to discuss about TCS Ninja Topper's test coding question. We will see the question, we will see its logic and implementation as well. So make sure you watch this video till end. Also, we have already uploaded many videos regarding TCS Ninja Topper's test coding questions. So you can watch them also. So let's move on to our coding question. So this is the question. Let's read it out. Let's understand the question first. Here given is, given an integer array and a positive integer k, count all distinct pair with difference equals to k. Now what does this question say is that we will be given an array, we will be given a value k, and we need to find all the pairs whose difference will be equals to this value k. Now let's see for this example. Let's see this. Like we have the array 1, 5, 3, 4, 2, and we have k equals to 3. Now, all the pairs which difference equals to k are, one of the pair can be 1 minus 4. If I take this absolute value, then it will be equals to 3. And then one of the, after this one or more pairs can be 5 minus 2, right? 5 minus 2 can be other pair. So this is one of the pair. And 5 minus 2 is also equal to 3, then this is the second pair. So all the total number of pairs are 2. And the output you can see is also 2. Now if I reduce this to 2, then the pair can be 4 minus 2, 5 minus 3, and similarly like this, you can include these pairs. Coming on to the next example, here we have the next example, and here k equals to 4. So first can be, one of the pair can be 8 comma 4, next can be 0 comma 4, 16 comma 20, and 16 comma 12, 8 comma 12. So these pairs can, well, the difference of each of the pair will be equals to 4. So total number of pair are 5. I hope the question is clear and simple. Now let's develop the logic of this question. So let's build the logic for our question. Let's take an example 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, and k equals to 3. Now, let's think of the solution. What we want is a difference. So what we can do is, we can do one thing, we can pick one element and we can check with all other elements whether my difference is equal to 3 or not. So one by one, first of all, I'll pick this element. Then for this element, I'll be checking with all other elements whether my difference is equal to 3 or not. If the difference is equal to 3, then I'll increase my count. Else, I'll move on to the next element. Similarly, then after checking for the first element with all other elements, I'll go for the next element and I'll do the same. I'll check the next element with all other elements. And if the difference will be equals to k, then I'll increase the count. So what is happening is, I have this array 1, 3, 2, 4, 5. First I have fixed my 1 and I took 1, and now I have these much remaining array, and I'll check whether the difference is equals to 3 or not. Here it's not equals to 3, so I move on to the next number, that is 1 minus 2. Similarly, it's not equals to 3, then I move on to 1 minus 4. Here it equals to 3. So initializing my count equals to 0, I'll increase it by 1. Similarly, I'll go and then I'll move on to the next number, that is 5. 1 minus 5 is also not equals to 3. So this is ending for this part. Then I'll move on to 3, and with 3 I'll check for all the numbers. So I'll check 3 minus 2, 3 minus 4, 3 minus 5, 1 by 1. Since all the differences are not equal to 3, so I'll move on to my next number, that is 2. And similarly, I do this for 2 and 4 and 5, and keep on increasing the count if any of the differences equals to k. So this is one of the simplest logic, brute force logic. We can optimize this logic as well. But if we want to implement this logic, then simply we will run one for loop from 1 to 0 to n. And then I'll take j from I plus 1, because we are considering all other elements after that element. I plus 1 to j is less than n. And for j is less than n, then I'll be checking if my a of i minus a of j equals to a, then I'll increase the count. So this can be one of the brute force solution, and the time complexity will be order of n square. So this is very high, and it may cause clearly time limit exceeded in your solution of for the few test cases. So let's optimize this solution here. Let's see what can be the improved solution for this question and how we can decrease this time complexity to order of n. So let's see that. Let's think of the logic for optimizing the question. So let's take my array again, 1, 3, 4, 5, and k equals to 3. Now if I what we were doing is we were taking up the number and we were finding up the pair with by we were finding up the pair whose difference equals to 3. Now whether now if we think, then we can think that like for every number there will be every other number, only one number, only unique number will be there whose difference equals to 3. Like for 1 there will be 4, and 4 is the only number out of the entire array whose difference can be equals to 3, and this can be the only pair. There can be no other pair, no matter how much I increase the array, even if I include any other number, but there will be always only one number whose difference can be equals to 3. So this is one of the case. Now my problem reduces to finding this number only. Or for 5, there's a, I need to find that this 2 only. So now my for every element of array A, my problem reduces to finding the other element whose difference will be equals to 3. Now I don't need to look for any other number. I just need to find this number, and I need to check whether this number is present in my remaining array or not. Now let's do this. Now if my A equals to 1 and K equals to 3. So my B can be, my B will be 4. Yeah, because A minus B equals to K. So for this, if A equals to 1, then B will be 4. Always in every case, B will be equals to 4, for which K equals to 3. Now, if my A equals to 5 and K equals to 3, then B will be equals to 2. Right? Because A minus B equals to K. So I got two scenarios. This is scenario 1 and this is scenario 2. Here, what I am doing is I am adding a plus k, and my b equals to a plus k, and in this scenario my b equals to a minus k. Now on which basis I am deciding this? Now on which basis I will be deciding that my b will be a plus k or my b will be a minus k? I will be decided with the help of this a. If a is less than k, then b will be definitely greater, and we have to add both a plus k. And if my a is greater than k, then I have to go for this scenario. So we got the scenarios, both the scenarios. Now let's see how we can find this number in order of n. Now what I'll do is I'll keep these numbers in one of the map or something. Now I'll take array first number array AR of 5 or AR of 0 equals to 1. I got the first number. I need to find the B for this. So the B will be, since my AR of I is less than K, and so my B will be equals to A plus K. That is A 1 plus 3, that is 4. Now I'll find whether in the remaining array I'm having 4 or not with me. So here I'm having 4. So I'll increase my count. Count will be equals to, now earlier it was 0, now it will become 1. Now going for the next number, that is 3, and since 3 is greater than equals to k, so it can be either plus or minus, so I'll be adding 0 to it. So whether is there any number in the remaining whose value is 0? So no, no number whose value is 0. So my count will be 1 only. I won't be able to find any number. Coming on to next number, that is 2. That is 2, and I have k equals to 3. Since it is less than 3, k, so we will add 2 plus 3. We will look for b equals to 5. That is my b equals to 5. Now I'll check if there's any number in the remaining array whose value is 5. Yes, we have that number. So we got the pair and we got the value of b. So I can use the found again. Now for the next number 4. For 4, is there any number in the remaining array? Since 4 is greater than k, so we will be looking for 1. But is there any number in the remaining array? We have either, earlier, but now my remaining array is just 5. So we don't have any such number in the remaining array. So my count will be same. So this way, my final count comes to 2. Now this can be implemented in the order of n. Here we are, I'm just picking one number and I'm just checking whether it is present or not. I'm not doing any searching at all. I'm just checking for the number. So this can be done in the order of n complexity. Now let's just write the general format so that we can understand it better. Let's write the general formula. In general formula, we are storing numbers in unordered map. We are storing somewhere. You can in C++ you can use unordered map to store all the numbers. Then what I'll be doing is pick one element each time. Now we will check either for a plus k or for a minus k depending on the value, depending if a is less than k or if a is greater than k, and I'll check if the if this element is present in the in my remaining map or not. If it is present, then I'll increase the count, else I will look for the next element. So this is general formula. Let's implement it. Let's see how we can implement this. So this is the code for the question. Let's see it one by one. For some So this is the code for the question. Let's understand this line by line. First of all, I have taken two values. One is the size of array, that is n, and other is the k, that will be the difference, what amount of difference we need to find between the pairs. Then I took the array and I put the values in the array using the for loop. After that, I am printing the number of different pairs I can find. So for that I have made the function, and this function will be computing the number of pairs. So let's see this function, how it is computing the pairs. Coming on to this function, I have first defined the max value, and then inside the function, this is a function, what I have done is I have took the count and I have initialized with the 0. Then I have took the one array, boolean array, and I have this initialized with false. Then I have took the values, and I have made them true. I have made the value of all the array elements true. What does this mean is right now all the values are available for making pair. Then I took the first value and I have checked if the x minus k is greater than or equal to 0, and in map x minus k is available, then count plus, or then I have again checked if x plus k is less than max, and in hash map x plus k is available, then increase the count. So this was our condition on the basis of which we were checking whether b will be x plus k or whether b will be equal to x plus whether b will be equal to x minus k or whether b will be equal to x plus k. And on the basis of that, if that b is found in this hash map, then we'll increase the count. Also, then I am making that value unavailable by making that value, the value of that value equals to false. So this is my logic. This is the implementation of the logic I made. Let's run this program soon to check the answer. First of all, I'll be taking 5 and 3 as the difference value. Now I'll be taking the array 1, 3, 2, 4, 5. And now running the solution, I got the solution as 2. I got the answer as 2. So we have already seen for this that answer should be 2, and that we are getting. So that's the answer of this question, and this is the solution for this question. Now that's all for this video. If you like this video, then please do like, share and subscribe. Also, if you want more such videos, then do mention that in the comment box. We will definitely consider that. Also, thanks for watching.